Hello, this is wmpyr. For today's lesson, it's going to be nice and short, but I do feel that it is a valuable lesson. It's something that I call blade awareness. And after training with the Lightning Arnis guys, it was something that I was reminded again. And it was something that I enjoyed watching them train and seeing their body mechanics and stuff. It was just something that it hit me personally, and I just thought that this would be a good exercise to return to. So let me share it with you guys. Okay, so the idea of blade awareness is basically you don't want to put yourself in a position where you have, let's say, double knives like this, or it could be single knife, okay, and you look really intimidating and stuff, and you think you're in a pretty good position, but right here, if my opponent somehow hits this hand, the hand that's in front kicks it, hits it with a stick or something and shoves it, or maybe even tackles me, okay, this can happen. So basically I ram my lead hand into the blade, and this is a very bad position for me now that I can really cut myself too. So if I get shoved like this, this is bad. So even though I look like I'm in a good position right here, if they know how to exploit this weakness, boom, then I'm actually not in a good position. So blade awareness is about avoiding putting yourself in situations like that, and also being able to identify situations where the opponent is putting themselves in a bad position. So what I want to do today is go to the Heaven 6. I think that's a good starting point. So let's go to the Heaven 6 with the sticks. Okay, so with the sticks, Heaven 6 position like this, and you're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now, the scary thing about this, in a way, is that because these are sticks, all right, you can develop a habit of where you park the stick like this. See that? It's on my arm right here. If this was a blade, this would be very, very bad for me. Number 2, 3, see, right here, and then I park the stick right here, right on the arm like this, because it's comfortable, it's convenient, all right? So as I'm doing, you see this position right here? See, I kind of do this kind of thing like that. So once again, right here, the stick is on my arm, all right? So now if you are aware that this is a stick, and you could actually, at a high enough level that you can control it, with a stick you can do that. With a knife, you can avoid it, all right? But if you're not at that high level to where you can control that so well, and under high pressure and stuff, it is going to be a good idea for you to add blade awareness to your form. Okay, so now when we go to the blade, we're going to apply that same concept here, okay? So when I'm doing the form like this, I don't want to be in a position where I'm going to park the knife right here that could easily be cutting myself. Okay, so go 1 and number 2 right here. You see, this is very bad. So one of the things that we can do is when we do the Heaven 6 in this particular example, number 1, number 2, you see, I make sure that the blade sticks out far enough and that my wrist rests on my arm instead of the blade. Right here, I make sure that it extends out. Number 2, number 3, okay, 4. See, I make sure that this is far out, not over here, far out, sticking out right here, okay? And you see, this is nice and protruding away and not inside right here where I am vulnerable. If they did this to me, this is a very bad situation right here. If they bent this arm, okay. So make sure here, if they bent this, I'm still okay. I'm still all right here. I can come out, okay? But if I got bent right here, and if I try to come out, I just cut myself really badly. So just make sure that you go past. It's a small thing, but it does take practice and awareness. Thank you for watching, and take care, folks.